two children, ages 11 and 6, that I'm really worried about. So I feel every bit of what everybody in this room feels. That said, I attended in Washington, D.C. this week, Brian Mast's Lagoon Action Day. And it may as well have been called the Bash the Army Corps of Engineers Day. I will tell everybody in this room and at home that the word sugar was not uttered once all day. It was the same tired song all day long from Marco Rubio, Brian Mast, Congressman Garrett Graves, and Bill Schuster, that it's all the Army Corps of Engineers. Never mind their own atrocious environmental voting records. Never mind their big donors who pollute the water to begin with. Never mind their support of a president who is dismantling the EPA along with the secretary of the EPA himself. Never mind their party whose primary goal, along with tax cuts, which equals defunding, is deregulating or unprotecting everything to promote fossil fuel profit. We cannot just keep cleaning dirty water. We cannot just keep banging on our chest saying stop the discharges that are not going to stop. Somebody read the mission statement. It's to prevent disasters. A flood is an environmental disaster. They're not going to stop the discharges for us and threaten other people. That's a choice of lives. Neither one is a good choice. They're not going to stop. Stop just saying that. I want funding and regulations for real change. It's already too late for me. I'm hoping it's not too late for my kids, and I definitely don't want it to be late for future generations. Our politicians are using this algae bloom to grandstand their environmental agendas, which is to destroy it for profit. Don't listen to me. Don't listen to them. Watch what they do. Check their votes. It's one click. Go to the League of Conservation Voters. Marco Rubio, 0%. Brian Mast, 23%. Look at their votes. Their answer is to dismantle and discredit the Army Corps so they can privatize everything. And what happens then? Who do you think is going to get those contracts? Who do you think is going to make the money? That's where the problem lies. You want it to not be a party thing? Find me a Republican who's going to fight for that and not corporate profit, and I'll be behind that Republican. Right now, there is none. So right now, it is a party issue. And if you want it to not be, then you find a candidate who will make it not be. But right now, the entire Republican Party's goal is to deregulate everything and promote profit by using fossil fuels. Check their votes. And stop just threatening one company, one entity who is regulated, who they take their orders from the President of the United States and the Department of Defense. So if you want them to change, you change those leaders. You change Trump and you change James Mattis. That's who you change. Get out and vote for a change.